Well, this has been a tough year for students at Seton Keough High School in Baltimore because two of their classmates are battling cancer.
But today, instead of feeling helpless, they really put their hearts and souls into action. And as Jennifer Franciotti shows us, they hope their efforts will pay off for kids struggling with devastating illnesses.
What we are doing goes beyond raising money.
The girls at Seton Keough High School are united on a mission to raise money, awareness, and support for two of their classmates battling cancer. The student body of over 500 at the Catholic Girls' School in Southwest Baltimore has organized the first Walk for Hope. It's in memory of their chaplain, Kathleen Bowen, who died last summer from cancer. Her death was just the beginning of heartache for the school. Freshman Keely Immel is battling brain cancer. Senior Shannon Wolf is now in remission after struggling with leukemia.
It's just so huge, and I don't think of myself as like a person that could make such a big impact on anyone, that they would go out of their way to do this for me and to be inspired to do it for other people.
I can't even put it into words how amazing it is.
We all are a big family here, and just the fact that we're all doing this for Shannon and Keely, we just all love everyone so much, and just we all kind of feel what they're feeling because we're all missing part of our family.
There's been a lot going on with like people going through treatments and cancer, so it's just a good way to pull everyone's spirits up from like thinking about the negatives of it.
But this is a positive. The girls are raising money for St. Jude Children's Hospital, walking in teams, working together to show their love and support.
They're going to make sure at least one person's walking at all times. We also have morale rooms that are in the school, so girls that want to take a break. We have quilt making going on, books on tape, the girls making books for kids to be able to listen to.
The Walk for Hope is just the beginning. Some of the girls are growing their hair for Locks of Love, and they have a mini fundraiser planned in May. In Southwest Baltimore, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.